Oh, that's still me. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our benediction, may you find that God's presence knows no end in you. And when old words die out on the tongue, may new melodies break forth from the heart. And where old tracks are lost, may a new country be revealed with all of its wonders. Amen. Stay in peace. And we now turn the view over to Sarah Gallup, our moderator, to begin our annual meeting.
Thank you, Will. And thank you to the ministry team and our lay leaders for bringing us such a lovely service. And Ken, your message was just beautiful. You've filled us up already this morning. So thank you. Well, welcome to the First Congregational Church of Winchester's 181st annual meeting. That's pretty good, huh? That's a strong history. I'd like to begin with a prayer, if you would join me. Nurturing God, thank you for being the common denominator in all of our lives. Your love and light guide us to plant seeds in your garden so that we may fulfill the potential that you see in us. We come together once a year in reflection of our service and work in your name and in gratitude to all in our congregation who give so selflessly of their time, energy, and talents. This past year has been challenging for us, as it has been for so many people around the world. As thinking and feeling humans, we are profoundly grateful for the way you lift us up when we are down, strengthen us when we are weak, and give us hope when things seem impossibly insurmountable. You helped us to reach out and to carry on. God, you and your son Jesus are the enduring inspiration for our everyday acts of faith and for our overarching purpose here at our church and in life. Thank you for being with us so completely as we strive to yield our fruits of love, compassion, and justice, and patience, gentleness, and joy. Amen. Well, again, welcome everyone, and thank you so much for staying on for the annual meeting. That's a moderator's nightmare, that everyone will sign off after worship and not come to the annual meeting. So it's great to see all your faces. I'm just going to start with a few housekeeping items. One is to call the meeting to order. And then to let you know that we are recording the meeting for a couple of reasons. One, to help with the minutes. Our clerk, Mary Ann Carter, will be summarizing our meeting today. But the other is so we can provide a link in next Thursday's email blast for people who weren't able to come today to watch the meeting. I want to acknowledge and thank our Zoom Kateers of the day. That's Bruce Alexander and Andy Spiegel. They are nothing short of amazing. And I also want to acknowledge the many leadership team members and ministry team members who will be leading various parts of the meeting today. I want to encourage you to use the chat at any time during the meeting if you want to offer a reflection or an observation. And we also will have a period of Q&A towards the end where you can ask any question or share any observation that you'd like. We will be taking two required votes during the course of the meeting. And when that time comes, you'll see a poll pop up and you will have already been briefed on it. And then you can just choose your vote, yes, no, or abstain. We'll be using slides for some, but not all of the meeting. And when we're not using slides, the speakers will be highlighted, But you know that you can choose to set your screen in any way that you like, on gallery view or to look at the speaker. And you're all Zoom experts by now, so we know you can make those choices. If you do happen to have any technology issues with the vote or anything else, just drop a question in the chat and the Zoomketeers will help you out. So I'm gonna begin by sharing my screen. And can everyone see that? Excellent. All I needed was a few nods and I got them. And we'll move on to the covenant and David Pretty.
Good morning. Would you please join me in reciting our covenant? We, the members of this church covenant and bind ourselves to strive to know the will of God, to walk in the ways of the Lord made known and to be made known, to exalt the worship of the one true God, to work and pray for the progress of knowledge, the promotion of justice, the reign of peace, and the realization of human community.
That's really cold. Yeah, excellent.
It's beautiful, isn't it? Let's move on to hear from Pastor Will.
All right, I'm unmuted now, I think. I'm not sure if all of you are aware of all that's happening around these busy few days here at the church. We just had our worship service, and now we're having our annual meeting, and soon there will be a gathering of Jake and the Stepping Stones family, the Forum Youth, and the adult leaders who have been walking our youth through the year. We'll be gathering out on the front lawn for a senior recognition time. At 1 p.m., I will be out in the Reno Garden doing, believe it or not, 4 baptisms for the Spring family, who's a relatively new family to our church. Walter Keelan, Walter, I think, is 8, Kellen is 6, and Isla is within her first year of life. And then their father, Kurt, said, I think I'll get baptized too, because I've never been baptized while I'm at it. And I was like, the more the merrier. So 4 baptisms at 1 o'clock out in the Reno Garden. And then later this evening, I'll be going over to the Wilson's household for Ben Wilson's Eagle Scout ceremony. Tomorrow night, as I mentioned, we'll be having the retreat and starting the 4-part resurrection series. And I'm just saying that the pandemic has not stopped us in our tracks, not really at all. Amen. Amen. And I mean, another good image for this truth over this past year that the pandemic has not stopped us. Picture this with me for a moment. And there are pictures out there, but I'm just going to paint the visuals in our minds for a moment. A parking lot. Picture a parking lot in Medford filled with cars, pouring rain, and in the cars are First Congregational Church choir members singing into microphones and their radios tuned so they can hear Jeffrey playing a keyboard and Jane directing out under a leaky tent, and the tent is nearly collapsing because of the gusty winds while Jane hangs on to it with one hand so it doesn't blow away while she's directing with the other. I mean, I'm just saying, and then there's Jen Richter snapping pictures in the rain with her nice camera, getting pictures through the windows of the cars. I'm just saying, the pandemic has not stopped us in our tracks. It's maybe required us to jump onto different tracks, that's for sure. But the church has just kept right on rolling here over this year. I'm also picturing Kathleen Zagata flitting around all our various towns with the help of such people like John Keeley and Richard Carboni, among others, delivering love to people in the form of flowers and palm branches and Advent goodie bags. And I'm picturing Reverend Judy, as you all know, always there for a good talking with wisdom and wit for you as the congregation and for us as the ministry team. Bundled up, I'm remembering her bundled up out in the parking lot late on Christmas Eve, another gusty night, and very early on Easter morning, a rather cold Easter morning. Judy not being a morning person per se, but she's there out of love. And I'm just saying, it's not, we haven't been stopped in our tracks this year. Amen. Amen. Jake stepping in valiantly to Ben's shoes in the midst of the pandemic. Sarah Marino still keeping the office running without a hiccup, ever available for so many various needs. And I'm remembering talking to our devoted building manager, Ed Banzi, all bleary voiced, bleary eyed, I'm sure, at 12:30 a.m. on Good Friday, as he's trying to figure out how to keep the alarm from going off during our Good Friday vigil, because it's hard to pray and meditate with a burglar alarm screaming in the distance. And I'm remembering many early mornings over this year in this big, lonely, empty church building, except for the sounds of Bill Lewis singing out of tune with his AirPods in his ears as he paints the banisters along the hallway or vacuums the floor. I'm just saying, pandemic schmandemic, the church has kept right on along running as it has for almost 200 years. That's how the Holy Spirit is working in our midst. And I'm just mentioning a few of these moments that kind of populate my mind, and mentioning to you the staff, but we can only do what we do because you all are a remarkable group of people who are so devoted to this church and have the Spirit of God in you and connecting you all. You're a loving and life-giving community that we are blessed to serve and serve alongside of so many of you, so many of the names that you'll hear or see on the screen when Sarah pulls those up. So speaking of being alongside of you, we are beginning to talk, return in person, to in-person worship of God together. We've been talking about it as a regathering team and as a ministry team and as leadership team. Lots of teams talking about it. Already, many of you are aware, we're beginning to open back the church building for various uses with clear guidelines and protocols in place. And we really thank the hard work over this year of the regathering team to help us think through that. But it's also true that we're not quite ready to be gathered and singing with gusto. And we all know how important singing with gusto is as a part of our worship service. It's central to how we worship God together. Just yesterday, Jeffrey was in here practicing. I came in for a baptism that we also had a baptism yesterday of the Ackle family. And Jeffrey was waxing poetic, imagining when the first time we are back in here, I cannot wait to hear people singing until the rafters are shaking and the paint begins peeling off of the ceiling and the walls. So that's what we need to do for Jeffrey's sake and for one another's sake. So we're not quite ready, but we are getting there. And we're going to do something soon. We want to hold an in-person prayer service in this space, in the sanctuary, on a weeknight in June. And we'll give you specifics coming up. An in-person prayer service that kind of ends the church year. And as it'll be a way for us to pray together to close the church year, and as something of a foretaste of what we will come back to as we return from summer for the fall. So keep your ears open for that. We're going to be working on that and giving you the date, and we probably will have signups for it in case we have a larger number than the sanctuary, which would be great. We'll do a couple of them just like we did on Christmas Eve. Now our plan beyond that is to begin regathering in the sanctuary for worship in earnest as we move into August and ramp up from there, so that come the start of the church year in September, we are adjusted and have kind of gotten the wrinkles out of being back together in this sanctuary safely and fully. The thing is, though, is that we want to ensure that when we invite people back into this sanctuary for our corporate worship of God, that for our weekly communal worship of God, that it is a full invitation to everyone. And so we want to ensure that that people can access a beautiful worshipful experience through live stream, even if they are not comfortable returning to the sanctuary. And that is still going to take some upgrading of our AV system in the sanctuary, and we're going to be hiring someone to run it. And that's going to be moving forward into the next year and years to come. A really nice way of live streaming on a regular basis our worship services. But we are working on that right now with that wonderful group that did both our Christmas Eve service, live streamed our Christmas Eve service and our Easter service. Jane is in and Bruce Alexander are in dialogue with them, and we're working on that. But our plan is to begin worshiping again together in person in August in the sanctuary for all who choose to do so, and continue making our worship available online for those that can't be present in person because they want to be in their pajamas during worship, which some of us have appreciated over the last year. So that is, as many of you know, one way we are already working to implement the strategic plan, which you've heard about now and which marks another significant aspect of this past program year and will mark the trajectory of the years to come, the technology being an aspect of that plan. We hope to, just a quick recap, to do some work around small group development for deepening our faith in God and relationship with one another. We will grow our children and youth program with a top-notch inspired, ordained associate pastor who will have crossover duties in other aspects of the church and with other people of the church as well, because we want to bridge and connect our children and youth and adult programs better together. And so with one person there in that position, that will facilitate that. And third, we'll be branching out to many people through Ripley, our advances in technological connection, like I've just been speaking of, and our continued outreach and mission work and justice work to ensure that we are spreading wide the good news of God's love that we know so well among one another. And that is our strategic plan, but of course, and absolutely, we continue doing what we will be, you know, what we've been doing in regards to our mission work and our worshiping together, our prayer services, the health and wellness aspects of what we have been doing as a congregation. All of that continues, and this becomes our plan and focus also for the future. So it'll be creative, exciting, challenging, and we'll do it together. We'll all work in it together. Oh, and this will unfold over the years ahead, all in the resurrected Christ spirit of love and for the purpose of that love. That's the idea. So towards that end, we are moving forth with one of the biggest initiatives of the strategic plan, which is the hiring of a new associate pastor for families, for youth and families. And we need you as a congregation to help us commission and bless the search committee. You did that 6 years ago when the search committee began their work to that it ended in what I found a pretty good result, which is bringing me here, and continues to, in my experience, to be a good thing. But that's, so that's what we're setting into here now again. And I really, and so we need you to help us to in this effort to bless this group of members that are taking this on, and to pray for them in their work. And I don't want to bypass that request quickly. We really ask you to hold the group and their work in your prayers, to pray that God will guide them, inspire them, that God will lead them to the person that needs to be here with us for their sake, because this is a remarkable place to be, for our sake, because God's going to bring someone among us that is inspired and excited and going to bring so much, and for the sake of the good news and God's reign, which is our thrust and our purpose as a church. So we've pulled together, and I'm bringing my remarks to a close. We've pulled together a wonderful group of 11 members of the church to serve on this search committee, ranging from ages 16 to 76. And we are assuming that their work is going to take about 9 to 10 months. And so by this time next year, but it probably will take close, you know, much of that time. If all goes well, we should have a new minister in our midst, and we'll say to our search committee, well done, good and faithful servants. So I'll end my remarks and hand it back over to Sarah to introduce this group of folks to you, and Judy and I will offer them a blessing with your help.
Thank you, Will. Thank you for taking us back over this past year and having us think forward to the coming years. It's remarkable in both ways, looking back and looking ahead. It does feel like we did the best we could under the circumstances that we were worshiping under and living under. So I'm going to share my screen and just pick up on what Will was talking about. I love it that Will says that we're going to hire a top-notch, inspired, ordained pastor. He just says that like it's a fact, and I think that will likely be the case. And all we really wanted to show you here is that the leadership team worked closely with the ministerial team to develop this charge, which I'm not going to read out loud, but you can read, to think carefully about the composition of the search committee. It was really important that many different sectors be represented on the search committee. And then we talked about the process. We'll be working very closely with our conference, and there's a guide to pastoral search and call that we'll be working within. And a couple of some background pieces that we've given to the search committee, which is sort of roughly how we see the responsibilities of this new associate pastor for youth and family shaking out. Those are those first series of bullets. Obviously, the real job description will be more detailed. And because we will be hiring a children's program director, it's important for the search committee to understand generally what the functions of that role will be as well. So this is background information that we've given the committee. And here is the committee. And you can see in each case, we've listed the sector. My favorite is Wise Elder. And we're so lucky to have youth with us who will be sharing two of the spots on the committee. So what we'd like to do is bless this group. And I'm going to stop sharing, and Will and Judy are going to lead us through that blessing.
Okay. Judy, are you there? Can we hear you?
I think so.
Okay, great. So we have many of those folks on the search committee here among us in this call, and we're not going to have them necessarily say anything or populate them on the screen. That's a little tricky, But what we would encourage you to do is go to your own view of, and make your, instead of speaker, you can go up to the right-hand corner of your screen, most people, and put gallery view, so that then you're seeing a large segment, you know, various pages and a large segment of people on your screen. And then Judy and I are gonna offer this blessing to the group, and we would ask you, if you are on the search committee, to bow your head, and then everyone else, if you will offer out your raised hand and note those people that are with bowed heads, and Judy and I will say the words of blessing so that we are all offering our blessing to them. So let us pray together and offer a blessing to this beloved group of our members who set into this task before us. Come, Holy Spirit, and fill the hearts and minds of these, your servant people, who have stepped into this role and offered themselves for the sake of your church to search for our new associate pastor for youth and families.
We ask that your wisdom guide them, that your spirit of honest, open, and loving communication be among them, that their minds and hearts will be able to discern clearly who our next pastor should be.
Grant them the grace to listen closely and look carefully, to choose wisely and interact sensitively, always attentive to how your spirit can move in subtle and surprising ways.
We pray this blessing upon them, that their work may bring among us a devout person of faith who loves you and will love our church, all our children, youth, and adults, and who will help shepherd us into ever deeper faith and commitment to Christ's work in this world.
And we pray that the work these faithful members of the committee take up, that it will bless their own lives as well and deepen their relationship with you, O God, finding in this process meaning, satisfaction, growth, and joy.
With gratitude for your constant presence all along the way, and hope for all that this new day might bring for First Congregational Church in Winchester, we pray in the resurrected Christ's beloved name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you all. And we'll move forward from here, but if there are questions about any of this process and where we're at, that can come, you know, that we are going to have a question and answer session at the end, right, Sarah?
Yes. Yes. And thank you, Judy and Will, and just a huge thanks to the committee members themselves. It's a very big job, and we recognize that. It's painstaking in many ways. And we want to be supportive of you. And you let us know when you need help. But we are grateful to you for volunteering or perhaps being recruited, whatever it might have been. But we're really looking forward to the process. So thank you. All right, I'm gonna share my screen. And we'll move on to a part of our program that is always deeply moving each year. And I'm going to turn it over to Nancy O'Connor.
Hi, good morning. My name is Nancy O'Connor, and I'm going to be reading the names of those who passed away in 2020 in our immediate and extended church family. Pamela May Berner, Janet Brewer, Mildred Millie L. Clare, Robert Bob J. Drummond, Martha Ruth George, Charles Joe Parker Harris, Marjorie Polly Kepler, Sandra Sandy Joan Northfield, Muriel Constance Penna, Janet L. Snover, Bartlett Clay Arnold, Jeff Ashworth, Harrison Bicknell, Louise French Blodgett, Hank Daggett, Michael Dinsmore, Thomas Tripp Hutchins Grosvenor III, Karen Jones, Howard Jewett Lamson, John L. Laughlin, Eleanor K. Topping, Marty Oppengard Rahmeyer, Margaret Perenick, E. Thomas Porter, Adelaine Weir, David H. Weiss, and Suzanne White. Now, please join us in singing verse 3 of the hymn For All the Saints.
Thank you, Nancy. We will keep all of those individuals in our hearts. I'd like to move on now to an acknowledgement of the annual report. I think annual reports can sound like a kind of a boring thing, and I want to try to dispel that myth. A lot of people worked very hard to summarize the work of their ministries, living ministries, sustaining ministries, any ministries that were active, that were able to be active through COVID, throughout COVID. And those ministries worked together to send in summaries of their activities, struggles, and plans for the future. Now, all of them are included in a single link that was in last Thursday's email blast. And if you haven't yet had a chance to take a look at it, I really encourage you to do so. You'll learn so much about what folks are involved in, what our ministries are doing. There's information there about church membership statistics. It's very comprehensive, and it captures a moment in time, our moment in time. And so I just want to encourage you to take a look at that at your leisure. It also includes, importantly, three sets of minutes from our congregational meetings over the past year. One is the May 17, 2020 annual meeting minutes from last year. One is the October 4th, 2020 Steeple Project meeting minutes. And the last one is the February 7, 2021 budget meeting minutes. These have all been summarized by our clerk and others, and we are required to vote on those and accept them and place them on file. So hopefully you did have a chance to look at those in the annual report, and we're going to move to a polling time, which gives you the ability to give your vote. So here comes the poll. Wow, that's pretty good. Zoom Kateers, I think we have almost everybody. Is that the case? You guys are good voters. And there are our results. So thank you very much. Isn't that just a wonder of technology that our Zoom Kateers know how to do that? Fabulous, thank you very much. All right, I'm gonna move on and go back to sharing our screen here. So, something that we talk a lot about at our church is, how do we properly thank people? Do we thank people enough? Should we thank people more? It's something that is really important to think about and even more important to do. So we wanted to use today's meeting, particularly because things have been so challenging, to express gratitude to all of you who are serving our church in a variety of ways. We're not going to read the names of every person, but we want you to take a good look at them. Look at each one of the ministries, look at the names of the people who are on those ministries. It might spark a conversation or an email or a chat or something like that. I think it's really important for us all to be knowledgeable of how many hands and hearts and minds we have working on the business of the church. And as we go through these pages, as much as we tried to ensure that everyone is included, it may be that we've made a mistake. And if that's the case, I encourage you to just write into the chat, pop something right into the chat that someone might be missing or something is incorrect. We'll make those changes, and then this will become part of the permanent record of this meeting. So don't be shy about doing that. So here is obviously our ministry team and all of our staff and affiliates, the people at the core of our operation. Here are our dedicated individuals who are working with our youth, the Children and Youth Faith Formation Ministry, our Stepping Stones teachers, our middle school teachers, and our forum teachers. I'll just let you take a look at all those names, all these wonderful people doing God's work with our youth. Here are the members of the Adult Faith Exploration Ministry, the Mission and Outreach Ministry, and the Diaconate. And you'll see throughout that our ministry team members serve on nearly everything. We don't quite know how they manage that, but we're grateful to them. Here's our choir and all of their beautiful voices categorized, and including our bell choir. Here's our facilities ministry, making sure that the building is functioning well, deciding how to spend our resources on critical repairs and improvements. Here's our financial resources ministry, helping to lead the stewardship campaign, inspiring us to support our church financially. Our personnel ministry, quiet work behind the scenes, so critical. Our new racial justice ministry, following up on the reading over the summer and our Juneteenth event last June, they're making plans for the future. Our dwelling place coordinators. If you haven't volunteered, if you haven't had the chance to volunteer at the dwelling place, it is such a gratifying thing to do. And our health and wellness ministry, that brings to us all kinds of activities, spiritual, reflective, and more. Here's our environmental justice ministry, a fairly new ministry. Our steeple task force, the heroes of the steeple. They made it through COVID and brought this incredible result. Our communications ministry, making sure that word about our activities get out into the town. Our outdoor church ministry and coordinator. Another tremendous volunteer opportunity. Here's our Ripley programming ministry. There's a lot of work ahead and excitement in Ripley. Our Reno Garden ministry, what a beautiful place. Our Habitat for Humanity coordinators and our coordinators of various groups for men and women, which all people are welcome to join these. Now here's a slide on particular COVID gratitude because these two groups formed because of the pandemic. One was the COVID Financial Relief Fund and the other is the Regathering Team. Both are continuing their work. Now, we have something very special, a surprise for you, and Cindy Vankovich will lead us in it. You ready, Cindy?
I'm ready. So on behalf of the leadership team, here are some special COVID thank yous shared in verse. It's been a year like no other, many have said, but through it all, our church has stayed vital. Due to the hard work of many who led, our congregation is active and faithful. Our COVID relief fund was generously funded to help those suffering and in sorrow. Thanks to generous gifts by so many, we were stunned. It brought hope for a brighter tomorrow. VVN was initiated to check in and show caring to many congregants whom we love. Reaching out, touching base to see how they were faring was a joy and a gift from above. New friendships were kindled and generations bridged. Relationships grew and spread. Errands were run, phone calls made, which encouraged us to stay connected and kept souls fed. Our love for the talented Zoom-cateers grew as you amazed us with your technical skills. You've kept us connected and in clear view and our need to be together fulfilled. Thanks to Bruce and Andy, and don't forget John, who recorded, edited, and screen shared for our live services when we took communion, visiting breakout rooms with friends who cared. Handling our finances, we have a great team. Bruce and Anne are gifted and deeply care. They're flexible and creative and can shift midstream to accomplish what others might not dare. Paying bills, finding loans, and handling the pledges of our faithful contributing members, all of whom kept their promises, he alleges, so we can pay bills our church incurs. The task force who worked on our spectacular steeple has earned much well-deserved gratitude. Dick's team worked hard for months to please all the people and always had a cheerful attitude. Our steeple now shines with a new cross of gold and rises so straight to the sky. It inspires and lifts up all in town who behold its glory we cannot deny. To our absolutely incredible ministry team, ways to connect seemed like a breeze. But with loving ingenuity and playful fun dreams, you held us up and lifted spirits with ease. How can we thank Judy, Kathleen, Jane, Jake, and Will, who have guided us through this tough time? Of uncertainty, fears, doubts climbing uphill, our hearts are filled with God's grace sublime. Our regathering team has worked tirelessly too, figuring out the new guidelines. Thanks to Ed and the others who've given us a clear view of the church's health needs and designs.
And now we think ahead with high hopes to regather in person in our glorious sanctuary, where worshiping together, we surely would rather praise God, sing, pray, and feel virus free. Amen.
Cindy, thank you. We're clapping.
You're welcome.
I just want to say about this that it's not like we sat around and said, oh boy, we should write a poem. What happened is that Cindy just said in an instant, I'm going to write a poem. And she did. Cindy, it's so beautiful and lovely. Thank you very much. And then I just wanted to show this slide. There it is in all its glory, our new steeple. Nancy, thank you for taking this picture. Isn't it gorgeous with that gold cross gleaming up above? We're very grateful to the Steeple Task Force. We know how hard you all worked. Thank you. All right, we are going to move on to elections, and we'll call upon Jason Ryan.
Excellent. Good morning, everyone. I'm pleased to share with you this list of members who are being nominated to various positions and over various tenures. Starting with the left of your screen, there are five positions up for election, and three of those have nominations today. Two of them are still in a search mode, and so I'll use this as an opportunity to say that if you feel called or if you know others for these positions of assistant treasurer or vice treasurer, please contact the leadership team or Bruce or the ministry team. But as far as the three positions there for officers who are up for nomination today, they are for moderator, Sarah Gallup, for clerk, Marianne Carter, and for treasurer, Bruce Waterwasser. And this will be Bruce's last year as he's at the maximal extent of that term for treasurer. On the right-hand side, you'll see three new nominees for the leadership team that we're really excited about. One for a one-year term is David Carpini, and there are two individuals for full three-year terms, Carol Cook and Christine Trusselt. Those are your nominees for this year.
Thank you, Jason, and many thanks to you and the entire nominating committee. You started many months ago, and we're so pleased with these results. And of course, we would have been pleased with any results. We're very excited about these new volunteers. And as Jason said, we will continue to seek an assistant treasurer and a vice treasurer. So let us know if you have any questions or thoughts on that. And now I'm going to stop sharing and we're going to go to this vote. This does require a vote and you'll see it pop up in a moment. It's fun to watch the percentages go up. You guys are good voters. We're getting very close. All right, what do you think, Zoom Kateers? Is that good? Is that close enough? Very high yield from that vote. Right, let's show the results. Wonderful. Terrific. Thank you very much. And congratulations to our new officers and leadership team members. We'll really look forward to working with you all. Great. Thank you. Okay. We are going to go on to a brief acknowledgement of some highlighted donations. And I'm going to turn this over to Bruce Lauterwasser and Ann Henneke.
Bruce, right, are you up for this? reason.
We're ready. We'll do whatever makes sense, Bruce. We and can give this summary.
Okay, I'll hop in here. So on the gifts and bequests, there were none this past year that require the congregational vote to accept. We've had a number of donations, as we always do, and this highlights the fact that we welcome folks to donate to our variety of funds that support different parts of the church. If you have a particular passion for a particular area, talk to me or Anne, or send in a donation. But we've had donations to different funds. Particular one we want to highlight this year, of course, is the Light the Steeple campaign, where we had over $60,000 donated that fully covered the steeple lighting, which had not been originally costed out in the original proposal. So that was a terrific response. We'll also note that the COVID financial relief fund that appears in the annual report, you'll see the disbursements there, but we've had a total of about $48,000 in donations. And up until today, I think we've disbursed about 38,000 of that. So there's still about 10,000 left to be dispersed. So that's been a terrific effort. And let me just take this opportunity, going back to the vote, we noticed that the assistant treasurer is TBD. And that's because after many, many, many years of faithful service, Keith Russell is stepping down from that role. Keith has faithfully counted the house for many, many years, counting the offerings. And of course, for this past year, that role has been on hiatus, but we look forward to resuming counting live offerings in the fall. but Keith will not be in that role. But I just wanted to highlight what a terrific job he has done as part of of our treasurer's financial team. So Keith, thank you so much.
Thank you, Bruce. And I just want to echo the Light the Steeple campaign was such an amazing thing, because we weren't sure if it was such a good idea. You know, can we do this? But there were many members of the leadership team who said, yes, I think we can. And we didn't want to burden the endowment any more than was needed. And the response was just incredible. We're just so grateful to be able to cover those costs with these donations. And then, you know, Keith, thank you for all the service that you've given us. And it makes me want to say something that I think is really important for all of us to think about. And that is that lots of people are rolling off their ministries. People have come to the end of terms, or they've made decisions about their lives that it's time to be doing something different. And my sincere hope is that every ministry will take the time to honor those who are rolling off and thank them for all of their work. So yes, Keith, we do thank you. And we thank everyone who's come to the end of their term or is moving on to do something different. All right, we're gonna go on to a report on new deacons and the head deacon. And I'll turn that over to head deacon Kathy Mortensen.
Hi, everybody. So as you can see from the screen, our big news is that our new head deacon next year will be Margie McIndoe, with the two new deacons, John Keeley and Janet Vaughn. We're looking forward very much to welcoming them to the diaconate. And also wanted to ask those of you in the group who are life deacons to be considering the fact that we may reach out to you in the not too distant future to see if there's somewhat willingness to support the diaconate in terms of scheduling going forward, especially as new routines and systems evolve as we regather. But we look forward very much to welcoming John and Janet and having Margie be leading the group going forward.
And Kathy, in a similar way, you're rolling off, and we thank you for your service, and particularly during this last year when it's been so so difficult. So thank you.
Thank you.
And congratulations to our new head deacon and our new deacons, and with one more to come. So I'm going to stop sharing now. And we wanted to leave a little bit of time for any Q&A that people might be interested in. If you have a comment, question, observation, the leadership team members, ministry team members, any of us will be happy to try to respond. So you can either just raise your hand or use the raise hand function, or you could just go on unmute and start talking. That's okay too. All right, and the Zoom Couteers are going to help me look for hands.
I put it in.
Bruce is laughing from his second home. All right, no questions. Is that a conclusion I should draw? Does that make sense? Lynn Raymeyer says yes. When Lynn Raymeyer says yes, that's the truth.
Sarah, I think I saw Keith's hand raised.
Keith, let's hear it. If you would unmute yourself, and we'd love to hear your question.
Do we still have a historian? I didn't see a name listed for that spot.
Oh, you didn't see a listing of the historian? Is that what you said?
That's correct.
That's good. And is that correct? Did you not list that? And if so, we'll fix that. Thank you, Keith.
Oh,
Doug?
Oh, yeah. Could you just list who the current ongoing members are of the diaconate and the leadership team members?
We can. Do you want to see that now, Doug? Is that what you're saying?
I could answer for the diaconate. So exiting the diaconate this year will be Aaron Neese, Carrie Erbar, and myself. So remaining will be Margie McIndoe, Nick Troisi, Megan Scipione, and then the three new deacons this year who were first years this year include Richard Carbone, Joni Valeriano, and Mabs Harris. And then joining will be Janet Vaughn and John Keeley.
And on the leadership team, these are the current members here on the right, Doug. And Marty Rosmanith, Cindy Vankovich, and David Peretti are rolling off. And coming on is Dave Carpini, Carol Cook, and Christine Tresselt. Other questions? Peter.
I just say from my wife, she's highly flattered to have been named earlier this morning to a committee, the oldest member of whom is 76.
Okay, all right.
We saw you both laugh when Will said that.
Will's laughing too. I think it's an inside joke, but we're glad you like it.
It's well known amongst the rest of us elders.
All right, is that it for questions? Any other hands? Zoom Couteers, you see any other hands? No, all right. Well then, we are coming to the end of our program, and we're gonna move now to a prayer from Judy.
So I invite you to draw your attention to God and prayer and listen to these words of prayer. Gracious and gathering God, we thank you for the people on this call at this meeting, those who prepared it, envisioned it, and those who will carry out all the ministries and future the future tasks that we have laid before us. We are a church on the cusp of a new life, as many are as we come back together physically, and as we are able to feel your spirit among us in face to face. Yet still we feel your spirit. We see it particularly from the moderator who glows as she makes everything look simple and sacred. This is the day that you have made. May we live into it and fill it with love as we have been given this morning. Amen.
Thank you, Judy. Mm-hmm. And we will now join together for our closing hymn. I'm not worried. Are you guys?
One moment.
My favorite line that Bruce Alexander has is stand by. And I feel like, man, I'll just stand right by. Whatever he's doing is good. Thank you. Kathleen Zagata will provide our benediction.
So our time has come to take leave. May the love of Jesus Christ bring us wholeness. The grace of God the Father grant us peace, and the breath of the Holy Spirit instill passion. O God, may your presence in the daily lives in our daily lives, and the strength of us as a congregation be sources of grace and blessing as we step forward into the year ahead. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Kathleen. And thank you all for being here today. And most importantly, for all that you do for our church. Bruce Alexander has motioned to adjourn, and Andy Spiegel has seconded the motion. All in favor of adjournment? The ayes have it. The 181st annual meeting of the First Congregational Church of Winchester, Massachusetts is now adjourned. Goodbye, all.
Thank you, Tara.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone.
Enjoy the lovely
Thank
day.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.
It was wonderful. Great.
Thank you so much. Peace to everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Have a wonderful day, all.
Where's Pam? Thank you, Cindy, for the poem.
Oh, it's beautiful, Cindy.
Great.
Yeah. Wonderful. Thank you.
Thanks for a nice
We'll have more
morning.
Time for that when she retires, right?
Thank you so much.
20 days. Yeah. Who's coming? All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Great singing, Tony.
Nice to see you, you too.
Oh, good to see everyone.
And many thanks to you, Ken.
Thank you, Bruce. Take care.
Seeing the written down version of that.
Me too.
All right. Are you doing a post meeting to do anything?
No.
No.
Okay. Hello? From yesterday?
The trick is, Sarah, is to close the windows when you need to and not mess up.
Oh, it was great. It was so awesome, Bruce. Thank you very much.
It was a really good program, Sarah. Yeah. Compliments to you and your whole extended group.
It was great.
All right. Have a good day.
All right. See you later. Bye-bye.